I know you've seen this picture on the news, Mrs. Asher, but if you could just take a closer look at it, please.
This was a female character, and this was a female's movie, and I thought it was also important to have a female editor, you know, to help with that voice.
This was a very character-driven film. It's about a killer's mind and the FBI agent's mind, and it's about interesting characters. And I would say that my work is somewhat character-driven or actor-driven in that way.
Depending on the scene, there might be a moment where the actor is incredibly compelling and good, but at the same time, it's not propelling your story forward. So how long do you hang on this moment? Is this moment vital?
And you usually cut the scene for what it's worth when you first cut it, you know, not allowing necessarily for where the performance is going to go. So you know you're going to have to go back in at a later date and change it a little bit. Then later on, when you get it all together and you see where her performance went, you go back into the earlier scenes and you alter things to suit where the performance is going later on.
Even the simplest scene maybe should be shot or played two or three different ways, because you want to be able to have control over how they behave in the editing room so that you can have this option or this option.
Only Martin reached the shore. That must have been devastating for you.
The first thing that you think about is what story are you telling, and then you start thinking about the suspense and the thrills and, you know, putting in the excitement.
People with thrillers and crime thrillers and in that genre, they have a certain expectation, and so it was a fine line balancing the drama, how long to hang on certain things, what to pace.
A lot of cutting is rhythm, so though you can go from one place to another or cut within the scene all over, it's got to have a certain rhythm.
Something that you thought was going to be incredibly special, or something that you compose and you figure, God, this is going to be the shot, and then you realize you really can't stay in the shot that you composed for the majority of the scene as long as you want, because once you get into a certain cut-in pattern, that shot no longer holds.
Sometimes cut it several times and it's not working because it should be working, and then you get the right moment. When we saw the Kiefer character give that wave, he used to drop a glass with a crash, and then they would all start running around. But it had a lot more of that suspense tension of longer shots. Now we've cut it quite quickly, and you get there very quickly. And it makes sense, because once she sees the Kiefer character, he obviously looks like a suspect. So how long can you hold her before she would react? So, you know, there were two ways of looking at that, and that was quite interesting. I thought you could kind of hold it. It's only because we know it's Kiefer Sutherland that we think she should react, but to my mind, she could have held back a little bit and been suspicious of him, but not moving on him immediately. It's exciting, that's why I love cutting.
Well, it's interesting because we have different styles, which is good. You know, she might like something that I hate, or I might hate something that she likes, but ultimately, at the end of the day, there has to be one decision that's made. You know, if you're empowered, and I was, thank God, in this movie, that it's ultimately going to be your decision. So you're either going to sink or swim with it, you know.